Hey everybody, here's a VFX video I put together recently of the Spruce Goose, and I've seen it appearing here and there around the internet with a range of different reactions from those viewing it. So here's a VFX breakdown video showing that it's of course a fake, and I'll go over some of the design choices I made in the composition. Firstly, I want to address the amount of engine smoke, and I certainly went overboard with this in the video, but not as much as people in the comments might think. The largest tier of radial engines in service before gas turbines arrived had enormous engine capacity, in the order of 70 litres or 4,300 cubic inches. And to put that in perspective, the average car engine has a capacity of around 2 litres. The Spruce Goose, or H4 Hercules, had 8 engines with a total capacity of 560 litres. And there's no escaping the amount of exhaust smoke that that creates. The Wasp Major engine in the Hercules was the largest aviation piston engine ever put into production, and is still seen flying in some aircraft today. Here's four of them fitted to a Boeing C-97. There's a noticeable exhaust trail when watching these aircraft from a shallow angle like this. And again on this B-29 bomber, which actually has smaller radial engines than the H-4 Hercules, and it's still producing large volumes of exhaust. And so, the exhaust trail from 8 Wasp Major engines on the Hercules at low altitude, with high power settings and a fuel mixture set to full rich, I think is only slightly exaggerated in the VFX video I did. Anyway, so the smoke trail was made in Blender using a particle system consisting of individual spheres of smoke. Each smoke particle instance was programmed to expand and fade over their lifetime, which simulated their dissipation. I used to do actual gas simulations for these types of smoke trails in the past, but this feature in Blender is beyond broken nowadays. And I was tired of waiting 2 days for a calculation to finish and then to find out the settings were slightly wrong or that it had artifacts during rendering. So without buying Ambigent, using a particle sim in Blender was the next best thing. I did a separate simulation for each engine and placed 2 vortex forces on each wing. This provided the initial downwash caused by the wing, and then over time the dominant characteristic becomes the rotation of the wingtip vortices. Here's an orthogonal front view which helps highlight the concept a little bit. Using only 2 vortex forces in Blender creates a really nice representation of the very complex fluid motion. And here's how the effect looks in regular perspective. Next thing I'll talk about is getting the static 3D aircraft models to look like they're flying. And starting off with the Hercules model here, this is an old free one I found online. Only thing I had to do with the model was animate the propellers. So to get the rotation speed correct, I had a look at some photos of the engineer's panel from an actual H4 to see the typical engine RPM in flight, then calculated the number of degrees it should rotate per frame, and working in radians here, so just multiply the degrees by pi over 180. I also needed to change direction of rotation, so I added a negative here in front of any one of the values. And then just copy and paste the expression for the other propellers, but also changing the values just slightly for each one. So this helps stop the propellers always being perfectly in sync, which looks a bit unnatural. And that's much better. Next thing is to add a bit of turbulence and motion to make their movement look a bit more natural. I just added some noise modifiers to the Y and Z rotation, and their X, Y, and Z position is controlled by a couple of nerves paths I set up for them to follow. And while following these paths, I also had to manually keyframe their roll so they enter and exit the turns naturally, being careful to keep the roll rate consistent with what would actually be achievable in the real aircraft. Nice and graceful, there we go. Once I was happy with the Hercules flight path, I could then bake in the particle sim, which ended up being about 50 megabytes each. To ground the viewer a bit more in reality, I added a Cessna 172 flying along the beach over the camera, which is only seen at the start and at the end of the clip. And seeing light aircraft chugging their way down a beach corridor is something most viewers are probably familiar with, and to juxtapose this with the Hercules, I hoped it would maybe subconsciously contextualize what was occurring just that little bit more. Next thing was the tracking. So the original blank footage needed to be motion captured, and it was captured using an iPad mini first gen, so I entered the focal length and the sensor size for that specific camera, and I always manually select and refine tracking points in the scene. I don't use the automatic ones as it never produces a good result for this type of panning shot. For the rendering of the video, I realized at this point just how much of a penalty I have to pay for the thousands of little volume particles in the scene from the smoke trail, with each frame taking about 3 minutes to render in cycles, so I was looking at about 42 hours to render the whole scene. This was the perfect time to go for some peer-to-peer rendering, and so I uploaded the Blender file to Sheepit and had the video completed in about 20 minutes. This way 200 other people can share the burden of my poor Blender skills instead of punishing my poor RTX 3080 for 2 days straight. It's completely free, and I recommend joining the community if you're the kind of person that can keep your Blender files below 750 megabytes. Now, with the video done, I just had to add the sound effects. I used the sound from a Martin Mars and Cessna 172 flyover, along with some other ambient beach sounds, wind noise, etc. There's also some other reverb and post-processing done to the individual sound files. And there we have it. Now, one thing I neglected to spend time on the original video was generating the shadows. So I made a revised version with shadows and also some other tweaks from the feedback I received on the original video. The smoke is now about 80% of its original density. The Hercules has a little bit more texturing and displacement on its surface, and also a cloud layer that replicates the clouds in the scene, which casts subtle shadows on the aircraft as they move through it. There's always something extra that can be added to improve the VFX, but it's all a matter of how much time you're willing to spend and invest in something this short and pointless, I think. And finally, just let me know in the comments if there's another aircraft from history or perhaps even the future that you'd like to see in a VFX scene, and I'll do my best to put it together. And thanks for watching.